Hi guys, today we're going to take a break from the book and we're going to do some IXLs. Same idea as the book, and I'll explain that in a few seconds, but it's really just has to do with the outcomes and the probability of certain events happening. So pretty simple. Look, Frank, from the other day, we did okay with probability. Just make sure when you are making a probability chain or when you're having more than one event, just make a little tree from one side to the other to find out the possible outcomes that there are, and then find out the situation that it's asking for. And April showers, that's not what you should write down. You'll just have to wait and see what the extra credit thing will be. For outcomes are the total possibilities that you can have, and then the probability is how many chances do you have for that to happen out of the total outcomes that are possible. So to find the probability, it's written like this. This is the probability of H happening. This is heads and tails, coin. Two possibilities, one is heads, one is tails. That gives us the chance of a heads is one, total possibility is two. And that gives us the probability for that. For a single die, six-sided, they're going to call them six-sided cubes because they don't call them die. I don't know, it must be from gambling or something like that. But a six-sided cube, the probability of one thing happening is the one. Like if you're going to get a three, the probability of getting a three is you have one chance, and the total number of outcomes or possibilities is six. So it's one out of six. So the probability of a three coming up is 1/6. If you have a spinner, and if they're all equal sized pieces, the total number of outcomes is four. So if I asked for the probability of brown, I'd have one chance out of the four possibilities. Now be careful for the IXL, the first II4. Here's just tricky wording. They'll say, what's the probability of getting an even number? So it's the probability of an even number. Oh, it's 3 out of 6. Then they'll say, what's the probability of all numbers over 5, but that are also odd? So just be careful. And in the second one, the II5, they throw some weird ones at you too, where they say, what's the percent of the probability for this? Instead of just saying, it's the fraction, because I like to have them as fractions, we'll say, what's the percent of this? So be very careful, look what they're asking for. Is there a percent sign at the end? Are they asking for a fraction? Does it matter between those? And remember, for probability, you can write it as a fraction, a decimal, or a percent. In II6, they're just asking for what's the probability of like two separate events. And just like we did the other day, we wrote down two or three events. To find out the number of outcomes, you just multiply them. If you want to find out how many chances of each, do write them out. Then you circle which ones are the similar that work out like that. Then you can figure out how many chances are. But pretty much it's just asking you like how many total outcomes are there. What's the sample space? So those they're using sample space outcomes. It's the same thing. In this case, you can just take the number of possibilities in each situation and just multiply them by each other to get the total number of possible outcomes. So there's two cards, so you get two chances. And there's the dice, that's six chances. So you just multiply two by six, and that'll give you 12 chances here. And then throwing that other coin in, there's two chances there, and you just multiply that, and that'll give you the 24, and that's how many total chances there are for those, or total outcomes. So to find out the total number of outcomes, instead of having to make the whole chart, you just multiply how many outcomes, possible outcomes here, times the possible outcomes of this situation, times the possible outcomes of this situation. Another example of that is to find the total number of outcomes of this. You would just take, oh, there's four possible things if you're randomly picking number from 1 to 4, card from 1 to 4. And if you're doing spinner from 4, four possible outcomes, multiply them by each other, and then you would get the 16. And you would see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and 16. Pretty easy that way.
So I gave you a lot of hints how to do the different IXLs. So for tomorrow, just IXL work, IXL, II4, II5, II6, it's all in sixth grade, has to deal with probability. Nothing too hard, I gave you a lot of tricks on that. And the extra credit for today, to get an extra point, and a lot of you have been doing that, which is very helpful, is it says April showers down below, and it's been raining quite a bit recently. But here is, you don't write down April showers. I don't know if you've heard of it, but this is something they say, April showers bring May flowers, because that's how you deal with April being rainy. So April showers bring May flowers, and here's what you're gonna write. But what do May flowers bring? So if April showers bring May flowers, what do May flowers bring? Write your responses in there. I don't care if it's right or wrong or whatever the case is. Find something, figure something out, put it in and submit it, and you get your extra bonus point. All right, get to it.